Welcome back, everybody, to another Northwestern College Overwatch match. We've been gone for a little while. We had a spring break this past week, but we are back and ready to start gaming. These guys are just fresh off of their spring break, and they are excited to be playing again after having that previous week with three games in 1 week. That was definitely a treat for all of us, winning all three of those matches. Actually, if I remember correctly, we are undefeated, winning all of our matches this season. Hoping to keep that streak alive and well today. We've got a game against Southeastern Oklahoma State University. That is a mouthful, and I will probably not say it anymore. I'm just going to call them Southeast. So we got Southeast coming up for you guys here. Going to be getting into map one on Busan here in just a few seconds. Let's see what the game is looking like. And there we go. Right as the last second counts down. Back at it. It feels like it's been forever since I've seen these guys play. But I'm sure I will be able to tell their unique style as soon as they start getting in this first fight here. Ronin on the Junker Queen. Probably my favorite of the heroes he plays. Southeast pushing very deep in on Northwestern's team. Amino falls. Point not going down yet. Southeast doesn't care about the point. They care about the kills. They get Ronin down first. Birdie finds the Genji mirror and takes him out. Says, I'm the real Genji here. Southeast captures the point. Northwestern waiting on their tank to come back. And here he is. LBV now falling behind on the Lucio. But the team is together. It is going to be very difficult to push into this competition here. We got Reinhardt on the enemy team just holding that corner. Very hard for Northwestern's members to actually do anything, but we see QWERTY and LBV go in the back line. Look for the Baptiste, but he's alive! And LBV might not be able to make it out because of that. A lot of split teams here, both sides. Ronin finds one. This Baptiste has just been staying alive, finally going down. A B hits two members of Southeast team. That's probably not going to be enough, as Northwestern has most of the team alive here. It's just the Lucio on point trying to hold off, but he can't. And Northwestern is going to capture that point here at 55%. We saw Northwestern break up a little bit there. We had the tank, DPS, and support go up top while QWERTY and LBV stayed in the backside, just kind of doing a pincer attack there on both sides. Ronin looking for the big kill there. Vacancho gonna find most of the kills here using his Kitsune, a distraction tactic that even fooled me. Big blade possibly here from QWERTY, finds one. LBV finds the other and cleans up. We saw quite a few ultimates there. Four, possibly even five. QWERTY, Vacancho on Northwestern's team. But the Reinhardt shatter into the Reaper combo was almost devastating. But luckily QWERTY was able to dodge it. Luke was able to dodge it. Help each other out there, use a big blade. Big Ronin purple here from his ultimate. Getting a few kills. Northwestern, a completely different team than that first fight. A team wipe. An unofficial team wipe there for the Raiders. Two ultimates online for both sides here. Amino having quite the defensive ult. And he's just backing up. He does not want to get dove on by that Genji. He knows that Genji has blade. He's playing the range here advantage. Genji's going to pop that ult, and he's far enough away, possibly going to find him. Helps deal quite a bit of damage to him there. But Raspberry is coming for him. Northwestern still has quite a few members alive. Ronan's going to find this McCree, possibly, but the healing from the Lucio is too much. Not enough. Overtime for Northwestern, 99%. It's a 2v2. And a huge pull there from Ronin. Getting allocated on the Genji. And that looks like it's going to be point one going over Northwestern. The Baptiste, Immore, and Window for himself isn't going to pull it off as Amino finds his shots. The score is 1-0 now here on the first map, Busan. If this is your first time with us, we always do a best of five. So we got five maps for you. First one to get three of those maps is going to win. So we rarely do see all five maps. Rarely do we see five at all. Northwestern going undefeated this season so far. But if we get to that third map there, I will explain that game mode. Each map is a different game mode, which is quite a unique part about Overwatch, that they have so many different game modes within a game. It can get confusing with the terminology and the way that the plays happen. Objectives change. But so far, we're going to do the same thing we did there, just a little bit different scenery. So whoever can capture this middle point there in the middle, this circle there, this square, I mean, surrounded by that big drum, is going to be the victor. A little bit different team comp. We have Yeetmeister on the Winston here. Looking for some dive targets, and he finds LBV on the Lucio. Amino down, only one support here for Northwestern's team. Vacantra not going to be able to make it out. And again, a repeat of what we just saw, Northwestern losing that point there. But that is okay. They are not worried. They were able to take it from 55% to 0 to 100. Losing that first fight seems to be in their blood. Dancing around point right now. Lucio boops the monkey away, trying to keep those squishier members of the team alive. Sojourn down. Ronin gets another raspberry down. It's a 3v5 here. Northwestern with a big advantage. Possibly going to capture this point if they can get those final few cleanup kills. There's one, two, and three. Northwestern capturing that point. Ronin playing quite far from his team there, you'll see, which is quite rare for a tank, but he was pressuring the point while his team was pressuring the players on SE's side, which made them have to choose one or the other, where Northwestern, they are taking these off angles. They're focusing the same targets, but making it very difficult for SE to find one solid target or one person to get a kill on. Ronin holds on to the pull and gets the kill with LBV. Moira coalescence here for SE's side, but it's not going to do much for him. Northwestern holding on to five ultimates. SE almost has four as that coalescence gets used. Possibly a little too late to save anyone on their team. Kitsune going off here for Vacancho. Just putting in a lot of pressure here. The monkey diving him, though. Can he get out? And he's out. LBV down, though. No support ultimates here for Northwestern side. And they lose Amino as well. QWERTY, a desperate blade here to try to hold on to something. Decides not to use the blade and get greedy and just run away. LBV popping his ultimate as well, trying to save the teammate. Vacancho falls. LBV's here, though, with the heals, but gone in an instant. Not a lot of heals here. Ronin going in with his ultimate, though. It's just ultimate after ultimate after ultimate, but no fight has been won. Double kill here for Northwestern, but the Sojourn Earl is cleaning up. Only Amino on point. Vacancho gets there, goes for the save. It's 99% in overtime. I don't know how Northwestern held on to that whole time. And they're going to have to back up immensely. They almost had that fight. It was Amino versus the world for a second there, and he held on and made it out alive. His ultimate is the sole ultimate in the game. potential for a big game-winning fight here with that. This ends now. Looks like he's gonna pop it. We'll see if he gets that pressure on there that he needs. Coalescence comes up though, and that's not good for him as that tanks straight through his health. Not looking great here for Northwestern. They find one though. Find another. That's gonna be big. That's the main heal gone. But Northwestern down two again. Rona just running around the point, but he doesn't have the capture. He's not getting anything from this. He's just trying to stay alive, but the blade comes out. Overtime's cooking. Amino touches. LBV just trying to hold as much as he can. Vakantra popping his ult, trying to keep him alive. LBV almost has his ult, 98%. Not going to be able to do it. And anyone, nobody gets the touch. It's 1-1 here on Busan. SE taking their map as well. Quite a close little game here we've got going as we head into the third point here on map number one. If it keeps up like this, we might see more than just three maps. Hard to say at this point, but these teams, very evenly matched. Good fights going on everywhere. We saw those ultimate economy. We saw Northwestern had all five ults online and popped quite a few of them in one fight. And although they held on to that point, they didn't win that fight, which put them behind in the ults. Nothing really game-changing there. And you don't need ults to win games, but ults do make it quite a bit easier for the team here. So maybe we'll see a little bit more tracking on those ultimates in use of those and in the different timing there. All right, Northwestern potentially going to break the streak here of losing that first fight on the point. And double kill there for Northwestern. That puts him ahead, but it's Met. Met from the side of SE finding two as well. LBV trying to escape here, barely making it, and he gets the boop. And Kiriko jumps to the monkey for the save, falls off the map as well. Commentator's curse not real as Northwestern wins that first fight. Alright, looks like Northwestern's doing a good job getting those ultimates close to being online at 75% here. This monkey jumps in, but is not going to be able to make it out with his life. The tank gone here for SE. That's never a good look. You never want to lose your tank early in a battle. Northwestern pushing back those forces. Kiriko barely making it out, but not with an ult. Not with anything. Ronan and LBV have their ultimates. We'll see if that fight starts early here. Yeetmeister throwing it over to the Junker Queen to try to match Ronan. I've yet to see anyone match Ronan's Junker Queen, though, so we'll see how that goes. LBV going to use his ultimate. Gives a lot of shields there for the team. And Ronan almost finds the kill, but Sojourn able to escape. Two ultimates out here for SE. And Quirt is going to use his and gets nothing. Gets bladed himself. Ronan with a big purple there. Finds quite a few. Possibly a kill here, but the Kiriko cleanses a little late, but Junker Queen still alive here, getting pocketed by both supports. Ronan only having LBV here, but he stays alive till 87%. And these two are just sticking together like glue. Birdie finds one, causing a bit of chaos here. Northwestern has the advantage. Amino probably going to be popping ult here. Wreak some havoc here as it's a 5v4. Double kill there for the side of Northwestern, repelling those enemy forces. Northwestern cap at this point at 87. Amino gonna hold on to his ultimate into that last little fight territory. ...99% win overtime. Amino gonna pop his ult, just put the pressure on. And he gets ulted by the Junker Queen, but no one's able to touch! Northwestern gonna take it here. Getting 2 points out of the three here on map one, Busan. QWERTY with the play of the game. Well done from both teams. Definitely a very close match here all together. We're going to be getting into the lobby, do some picks and bans right here in a second. We'll be right back with you when we head into map number two. Here we go, back into map two. We're on Junkertown this time. I am unsure if we've ever seen the Raiders play on Junkertown this season. We normally see Route 66 or Shambhali Monastery, but we're looking at Junkertown today. Excited to see a map that I don't recall seeing in previous games, so... as we head into this, I do want to shout out to our sponsors, HyperX. Thank you, HyperX, for all the great gaming peripherals that you give the team. That is what allows them to play at the top level that these guys are playing. Undefeated doesn't happen without great gear, and great gear is HyperX. Quite a slow little start here as we wait for that payload to move forward. Northwestern not showing. SE's probably wondering if Northwestern even connected to the match right now. No idea where they are. Looking around for them. Looks like Northwestern's going for the surprise tactic. And the boop to get to Cassidy in the big sleep. Anti-nade on the Sigma. Sigma's not looking healthy right now. The Baptiste goes down, and Northwestern is playing the game all in an instant. Quite a cheeky little comp here from Northwestern. Hiding out and around, and only showing when they want to get a kill. Not a very pokey comp. Definitely more divey in a sense of just trying to get those burst damage kills. Genji not looking too hot here for SE, and he's gone. Northwestern supports gonna need to rotate out of here because they have quite a bit of the attention on them. OBV getting walked on here by the Sigma. And Reconcho down, both supports here for NWC down, and Amino sleep on Ronin and an anti-nade. Most of Northwestern members down. QWERTY just is trying to escape with his life, if possible. He's looking for the kill here on the Baptiste. Finds the health pack. Does he have the 1 second he needs to hit the recall? And he doesn't. Ronin ulting the point with 1 minute and 29. 1 meter and point 29 to go. Sorry, and point has been captured into the checkpoint. That is rare that we see from Northwestern on defense losing any of the checkpoints. So we're definitely in for something good if they bring that down. Definitely a close match. And QWERTY just running around this Genji, not wanting to take that 1v1 and wanting to wait for his team to be at full strength. Amino finds Jaggy. Ronin in the backline on the Ana with QWERTY. And they almost find her. She's one health. Ronin dies and the Ana is still alive. Oh, QWERTY almost getting this kill using Luke's orb there. Finds Raspberry. Raspberry not even realizing he's the real target in all the shenanigans going on behind the scenes. Northwestern up one, up two. These anti-nades and sleeps for both teams are looking mighty, mighty juicy. Lots of sleep darts hit, lots of anti-nades hit, especially on those tank players. Definitely not fun as a tank to get slept in the middle of the enemy team. Just a little under 3 minutes here on the push. As SE tries to go for this next checkpoint here. Nano boost onto Ronin here from Reconcho. Finds one, QWERTY finds another. There's the tank on just through from a roll through. Not even a shot fired from Ronin. He's looking for this Kiriko, seeing if he can get her. Able to swift step out of there, go back to her team. But QWERTY, trying to find that finish. These two, they've been playing together for a while. They love this dive comp. They have the timing down very well to find the targets. who's the weakest link on the enemy team, and not necessarily who's not as good as the rest. It's the character. It's all about what utility can I get rid of for the enemy team. Generally, that's going to be a support player. Go for the healers, and that's what these two mobile characters, Ronin and QWERTY, on the Wrecking Ball and the Tracer, are continually doing. As Amino, Vacancho, and LBV set up a fortress here, just poking from long range, pumping in that damage. They two ultimates here, Amino and LBV with theirs, and about a minute and a half left to go for SE on this attack. Cassie's gonna find QWERTY there on the Tracer. Northwestern down one. Big transcendence here and a big sleep. Northwestern just not wanting to fight right now as they had the blade going. Northwestern finding the kills they need. Amino with the nice headshot there at the end to take out the Kiriko. This is last fight territory, and Northwestern has the ult economy. Three ultimates, possibly four by the end of the, by the time that this fight is about to end from Vacancho. Looks like QWERTY uses his ult. Nothing gonna be happening from there, though. This is last fight territory. Ronin very low here. Gets anti-nades, but finds one with the big minefield. One nano coming out. Nice kill there from Amino, finding the support player in the back line. Hitting that discorded target, and finds a Tracer, just flicks to the head. I'm gonna say it here first, folks. I think Amino's hacking. Just hitting headshot after headshot. Incredible. I only joke. These computers definitely don't have any hacks on them. I've personally checked them myself with Coach. Amino just on one. Spring break. Not sure. I'm going to have to ask Amino what he did over spring break, because it looks like he just went to the firing range and was practicing hitting headshots. Looking very clean on the Sojourn tonight. Well done, Amino, and I'm sure that that HyperX gear makes it just that much easier to hit those shots. We're going to have to ask him about that later. Northwestern going on to offense now. We saw that payload get moved all the way into the second point for SE, and that is Northwestern's goal as well now. This glowing rectangle here is the end destination for Northwestern now. It's a dynamic game mode here on the payload maps. So we'll see if Northwestern, in the time allotted to them, can push it just as far as they were able to hold it from. Now we do see Ronin and QWERTY on the same composition. We'll see if they go for a similar tactic, but if you look at the top right of the screen, Alucade swapped to Sombra, known as quite the counter to a dive composition of like Tracer and Wrecking Ball. So SE being a little tricky with the team comp, swapping it up a little bit, just trying to counterplay Northwestern's characters currently. We'll see if it's any good for him, if it helps him out. Maybe he's even just going for the support players. Amino on high alert for the Sombra. Ronin finds the Sombra, one down. Four to go. QWERTY's working in the back line here. Vacancho finds one with the snipes. Looking for this last support player. And this Baptiste just has nowhere to go. Ronin and QWERTY, just the pincer attack with just the two of them. Ronin looking straight past this Sigma, saying, I need that support player dead. And finds the Moira with the help of Amino just coming in. DPS and Tank just playing the off angles off of each other. Northwestern, a great job of communicating. I'm sure these comms are loud and proud, talking about where to go, who to shoot. And you see Amino played a little differently there when it was that last part of this point. Not playing that far away playstyle with the poke comp, but getting right into that melee range with Ronin, looking for those final cleanup kills. And that's not good for that Sombra, not able to make the translocator up to the top. Ultimate's online here for Northwestern. We'll see if Ronin's gonna try to boop off of the high ground here. And he does, and there goes the ultimate. Almost like he's listening to me as I commentate the game. Ronin, if you're in here, you gotta be paying attention to the match, man. Vakancho gonna be popping that ultimate here on Ronin. He's looking for the support players. And the EMP gets canceled. The LBV with a huge cancel on the EMP. That is not what you want to see if you're SE right now. Maybe the biggest ult for your team to turn this fight around, and it gets canceled by the Zenyatta of all people. Didn't get slept, just got straight domed. And Northwestern gonna be taking map number two. Junkertown in quite a quick push here. Northwestern great at those escort maps when they have to do that offensive side. That defense is always good, but their offense is always impressing me. This might be that EMP cancel right here. We're gonna see it right as she tries to click it. Nothing though, and finds one of the supports, pops the transcendence for his team. Great play there from LBVD to BLVD on DVD. Map 2 going over to Northwestern. This best of 5 is looking like it might be another 3 game in and out like Northwestern is so used to. We'll be right back when we get on to map number 3. Alrighty, we are back on a map 3. We've got Suravasa. Been a little minute since we've been on Suravasa for our Flashpoint map. But we are back and ready. If you're a longtime viewer of Northwestern Esports, you will know that Flashpoint is probably the guy's favorite map to play. Just in general, this game mode, they are the best at this, in my opinion. Maybe it isn't their favorite, but it sure is my favorite to watch them play because they just come alive on this map. It's a much quicker game pace, and I think they excel at that. I think it's because of all the time they put in together, just working together. They all have it ingrained in them. Who's going for what target? Where am I supposed to be? The timing of getting on a person, getting that kill secured, and then moving to the next target is just, I mean, it's rinse and repeat. These guys are able to do that in their sleep almost. So I think this game mode is very conducive for that play style that they're very good at. We see Northwestern capturing that point already, and this percentage is moving a lot quicker than in previous game modes. Already at 40% for Northwestern here. Control almost getting pulled. He's very low here, but gets a burst of healing there from his Suzu. Under my protection. Fighting off the enemies once again, playing a little tower defense now. King of the Hill, and Northwestern possibly going to go grab this point without any more fights as it's 85% and moving fast. They're just going to be looking for the next spawn point here and where they're going to fight. Looks like it is going to be over here to the right. Next flashpoint, Palace. The Northwestern going to be making it first to the palace here, the next flashpoint of the map. SE coming in behind, 5 strong, hero swap to the Orisa. And they're looking to play a brawl comp, looking like they're just pushing straight in for the brawl meta. Baronin's in the backline, going for the supports, finds one. The Orisa had no idea, was not ready for it, pushes straight past Ronin, looks for Northwestern supports, and one of them goes down, Ronin goes down as well, but overall, Northwestern coming away with the victory on that fight, 2 of their members alive still. 5 ultimates for Northwestern here, Yeetmeister swapping to the Mauga, not sure what hero to play to counter this playstyle. I'm not sure what to play either. Ronin's a sneaky guy. He hides in those corners and just goes for the supports when you expect him to tank straight on tank and continue to fight like that. The sunlight suits. Let's see what ultimates we're going to be having this fight because Northwestern has the economy to start using. Kitsune and Blade coming in. 1 kill, possibly 2. The Kree falls out of the immortality, but QWERTY doesn't kill him. Ronin just face tanking the Mauga here. Gonna get the kill as well. Hold off as long as they can. 70%. I'm not sure if anyone can touch or not. It looks like they got a Tracer possibly going in for a touch. But there is less than 5 seconds to go on that point. And Northwestern still holding on to that ult economy with 3 of them, only using 2 to win that fight. Flashpoint number 3 coming in. If Northwestern takes this flashpoint, they take the map and the game. It is all or nothing here for SE. They've got to just throw everything they can if they want to continue to play tonight in this game. They do get to the point first. Northwestern fighting the battle here. It's go time. Amino gonna pop that ultimate. Mauga jumping in on him, trying to get rid of Amino. Amino finds a Tracer though with a crazy pick out of nowhere. 1 ultimate coming out here for SE, but it's a little late as Northwestern has 5 versus 3. Two supports and a tank for SE. One support and a tank now. Samora staying alive in the Mauga. Finally gone as well. That is a timer you don't want to see, is your respawn timer as the enemy gets the percentage taken. In SE, not coming away with any percentage, unfortunately. They weren't able to cap as Northwestern just kept the foot on point at all times. LBV and Vacancho, the only two with ultimates here for Northwestern. Trap already, Vacancho falls. LBV not going to be able to use his ultimate to save Vacancho fast enough. Northwestern not looking great. Both supports down and a tank. QWERTY and Amino just trying to hold on for dear life. QWERTY not holding on for dear life and letting go for dear life as he falls to the edge of the map and gives up the point. 62% completed, though. Northwestern looking just to win one, maybe two fights here, depending on when they can cap in that. Kitsune and possibly a blade coming out. No, QWERTY's holding on, waiting for that beat to go away. Great game sense for QWERTY, knowing that beat was there. Just waiting it out, waiting until no one had that shield. And finds a double kill, possibly a triple, and there it is. Team White for Northwestern taking out SE. They have the point. And it's going to be a while till anyone can get back. Ronan already with his ult, pushing up. Gonna use his ult early, but doesn't hit anyone, actually. Gets stuck on a corner of the map. SE just trying to get the point, but they can't. Northwestern knows what they have to do. The Doomfist in the backline on point. Not a lot of help here. The Moira comes in, but gets picked by QWERTY. That's gonna be it, folks. That's gonna be the game. Northwestern coming home with another dub. Completing this end, this undefeated season for another week. GG's in the chat from both teams. We will be right back after this play of the game. I'm gonna go grab one of our players and you can hear it from them to see how this game went, how they felt coming out of spring break, what the nerves were coming in. It was a great match here tonight. Well done, SE. We loved playing against you guys. And good luck in the next match. If you're still watching with us, stay tuned for this post-game interview. Alrighty, we've got one of our team members here, ladies and gentlemen. We got OBVD, BLVD, and DVD here for ya on the mic. Luke, how you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great after that 3-0 win.
Another 3-0 in the books, undefeated continually for Northwestern. How are you guys feeling coming off of spring break? I know it's been a while since you guys have played together. Was that a cause for any stress for you guys?
You know, a little bit. Anytime you come off of a break, you're just out of practice, out of your normal routine. So just playing at your normal height is a little bit harder. But, you know, we were focused over break. We practiced and we came back not rusty at all. And I think, we definitely surprised them with that.
Yeah, I mean, you could see it. There wasn't as much rust as I was expecting. One of the players I noticed, Amino, just hitting headshots on the Sojourn tonight.
Oh, yeah.
You guys were all looking clean. But there's one moment in the games that I got to ask you about, Luke. We saw a crazy EMP denial from Zenyatta, of all people.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Was that a planned kill? Did you know that the EMP was coming, or was this just kind of happenstance?
I walked up those stairs to that high ground, and I knew the Sombra would be right there. I was like,